So I'm going to show you how to my roast chickens for my Sunday dinners. Preheat them over to 180. Underneath the skin on top of its breasts, a couple of slabs of butter. Generous amount of salt and pepper all over. Then into a bowl I've got some softened butter, garlic, rosemary, thyme, a little bit of lemon juice. Just mash it together with the back of a fork. Cover the entire chicken with this butter. Lemon wedge and a sprig of rosemary up its battery. Then into the oven. At the 45 minute mark, take it out and give it a good baste. Just look after it. You want it to be nice, tender and juicy. Back into the oven for another 45 minutes. Lay it rest for 10 minutes. Bon appetit.
Hey, it's Dean. The cold Sunday in Philadelphia area. So today we're doing a nice pot roast. We're going to have it at halftime of the Eagles game, so I'm getting started now. I've got some hot olive oil going. Always like to season my olive oil. Put a whole clove of garlic in. You can pull it out later. I'm also going to throw a sprig of thyme or rosemary in, which seasons the olive oil. I've got a nice chuck roast, which is my preferred cut when I'm making a pot roast. As you can see, I cut little slits and put just a little bit of garlic and rosemary in each one. And we're going to give this a really good sear on both sides and all the edges. This has been well salt and peppered, and I'll show you how brown you want it before you turn it over. Right, you really want a nice sear on that, because that brings all the flavor out. Hey guys, this has been browning for about 10 minutes now, all sides, including the edges. We're going to remove that from the pan, put that aside. And now what we're going to do is we're going to deglaze this pan with our vegetables. We've got garlic, celery, and onions. We're going to throw that in there with a little fresh rosemary.
Wait.
Splash of beef stock. A little fresh ground pepper and kosher salt. Season your vegetables. Go Eagles. Yo, we returned our beef to the pan. We're gonna add a little bit more stock to about halfway up your chuck roast. This is about a quart of beef stock, but it's a big chuck roast. I've got some beautiful baby carrots here. Now we're gonna arrange around and got a nice one dish pan here. We're gonna top off with a little more fresh rosemary and thyme, and we're going to put this in the oven at 350 degrees for about an hour and a half. It'll be perfect.
What happened?
Apparently the potatoes are fucking good. Should I not say fucking?
It's okay, because...
because the dog got up on the countertop and started eating the potatoes.
Wasn't you.
The garlic parmesan mash.
It was you.
Sunday dinner's ready. Go Birds, Eagles time in Philadelphia. Oh, I'm racing over to plead my case. Oh, she saw it was me and slammed the door in my face. Fellas, tell me why. How come we always doing wrong? Doing wrong. How come we can't keep it home? Keep it home. How come it always is like this? Even though we know.
So doing a Sunday roast doesn't need to be stressful or hard work. Even if you've got a tiny little shit kitchen like mine, with a bit of careful planning, it's a piece of piss to do. The night before, I get my leg of lamb into the slow cooker on low. Just let it cook through the night. And just look how tender this is the following day. Just falling off the bone. Absolutely gorgeous. I start with the roast potatoes because they take the longest to do. Just peel them off, chop them up, get them onto boil for 15 minutes. Then into a baking tray, I've got two onions, two carrots, two sticks of celery, thyme, bay leaves, rosemary, a little bit of olive oil, salt and pepper. I've got my joint of beef. Got me loads of salt and pepper all over it. Just massaging some mustard powder. Into the oven, 20 minutes, set at 250 degrees C. When the potatoes have softened, drain them off, ruffle them up, cover in salt, pepper and flour, and let them completely dry. While they're drying, all into a baking dish and get it up to temperature. Take about 15 minutes. Get the potatoes in there. If they don't sizzle when you put them in, don't put them in. Oven down to 180. Let them go for half an hour. Then into a bowl of added garlic, rosemary, thyme, a little bit of olive oil. Give it a mix around. Half an hour later, flip these potatoes and add your garlic and herbs. Back into the oven now for another 45 minutes. Now let's start the Yorkshires. So 250 grams of plain flour, 4 eggs into a bowl. Give these a good mix, then add them into the flour. Give this a good stir. Then gradually start to add milk, about 150 mils. Mix it well and it should eventually look like this. That's the consistency you're looking for. I've got the tray for the Yorkshires, a little bit of oil in the bottom of each one. Get that into the oven for 15 minutes. The beef's been going for about an hour and a half. I'm going to cover it over, let it rest, and don't waste any of this in the bottom of the tray. We're going to make the most stunning gravy out of this. Get it onto the hob, add red wine, let it bubble away and reduce, then cover the whole lot in flour. Mix it well, then add beef stock. And don't waste any of those juices out of the slow cooker. Add that in as well. You'll let it simmer for about 15 minutes. When the oil's up to temperature, add your batter in and get that into them for 20 minutes. We're in a good place now. I've boiled off some baby carrots and green beans, drained off the green beans, and then I've added butter, garlic, crispy bacon lardons. Finish the carrots off with some lemon juice and fresh parsley, and then drain off that gravy. Who the fuck needs Bisto, eh? You've now got all the elements to assemble a fantastic Sunday roast. Just look at that. Bon appetit.
Listen, Sunday dinner is not complete without mac and cheese, and mac and cheese is not complete without Carnation milk. So let's get into how my meemaw makes the best mac and cheese on this side of creation. To the Carnation milk, you're going to add 1 egg and a dollop of Daisy, some ground black pepper, and whisk away. Going to set that mixture to the side and get started on the cheese. Okay, boom. So a million different ways you can do this. I'm doing sharp cheddar, smoked Gouda, and Jarlsberg. You can do this however you want it, but make sure that you grate the cheeses by hand. It's better that way, believe me. And now we build the macaroni and cheese layer by layer. This is my favorite part to watch my meemaw do. Completely cover the bottom of the pan with noodles, then completely cover those noodles with cheese, then completely cover the cheese with more noodles, and then back and forth until you use all of your noodles and all of your cheese. Shout out to my meemaw, man. They don't tell you when they ask you to bring the macaroni and cheese that it can possibly be the most expensive dish to bring, especially if you love the people that you're making it for. You want it to be right. So love you, meemaw. Thank you. Speaking of love, butter. That's it. That's the quote. Butter. Just butter. Put butter on the top and then you pour in the mixture. And you want to pour enough in to make it kind of soupy that it moves like this when you pick it up. A lot of old-fashioned cooking requires you to just know and feel when the food is ready. Meemaw said, oven on 375 until the cheese is bubbly and beautiful like that. Took me about 35, 40 minutes. I'm having company over, so for presentation purposes, I can't dig into it, but you better believe this was good.
So this is what I made for dinner tonight for my girls. I really don't know what to call this, but it came out delicious. Just season your chicken thighs, add some butter to the pan, let them brown, and then stick them in the oven for about 30 minutes. Now we're gonna make our sauce to go over our chicken and our potatoes. Be patient with your sauce. I like using red skin potatoes. So that's what I'm using here. Your seasoning and your butter and your Parmesan cheese. Hand mixing is fine. Now we're going to plate. Our chicken looks so good. Top it off with a sauce that we made. Look at that.
This is the best pasta with the least amount of effort. Saute some onion and garlic and season it with garlic, salt, pepper, and Italian seasoning. Add 1 can of diced tomatoes and some heavy cream. About 1/2 cup is good. Whatever pasta you choose is fine, just add a little pasta water to the sauce. Now re-season it, but add garlic powder this time. In go the cute little bow ties, and here's where the spinach comes in. Keep adding as many handfuls as you want and just fold it in, it will wilt very fast. Now add a little Parmesan cheese, give that a quick stir and you're done. This is so good and so delicious, and now that you watched the whole video, I'm sure you can see why.